Very good morning to everyone. Dear students, in the last class we have completed the circles topic. Now today we'll discuss about the fifth topic of arithmetic progressions. I hope sir has completed up to the exercise number 5.1. Even the exercise number 5.2 also he has started. Then how much part he has taught, the remaining part I will teach. So, see, this lesson is very important in the next studies, in higher studies, like a first, second, and even in the future study also. See, one more point you have to remember, in the competition, in the competitive exam, this lesson is very important. So, what is arithmetic progressions? Now, progression means it is develop, progression, progress. See, in the, we can observe in a nature, many things follow a certain pattern, such as petals of sunflower. You know that how it grows, the petals of sunflower, the holes of the honeycomb, and the grains on maize. See how it is progress the grains on the maize. That is in the increasing order or in the decreasing order. See the grains of the on maize, it is in the decreasing order. Same size it will be a progress. Now these are the all examples of the progression. Now see, before I starting that exercise number 2, I think up to 2nd main or 3rd main sir has completed. Now see that before that I will just recall the what are the basic things, basic points of the arithmetic progression. First you should know what is the arithmetic progression. See the definition. See arithmetic progression, it is a list of, see the definition of the arithmetic progression, it is a list of numbers, list of numbers in which each term is obtained, each term is obtained by adding a fixed number, to the preceding terms except the first term. See the definition, what it says, that this is the list of a number in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding terms. See that to the preceding term, succeeding and the preceding means to the previous term. Preceding means a previous term. Now see the, for example, 1, 3, 5, 7, so on. Clear? Now see the A, first term, 3, second term, third term, fourth term, so on. Now term is obtained by adding the fixed number. See what is the fixed number here? See what is the difference of the first and third term here, first and second term here? 2 here, 2 difference here, 2 different. Adding the fixed number to the preceding, to the before terms, now except the first term, except the this first term, now such numbers are called as the AP. What is that? Arithmetic progression. Now see, we know already in details about this one, we already studied. Now just I will recall, now 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a first term. Now first term is denoted by the symbol A, this is A2. A3, A4, so on. Last term is denoted by the AN term. This is the last term. Now see 2, 4, one more example of the AP here, 6, 8, so on. I'll write here 100. Correct. Now observe these three APs here, or these two APs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 3, 5, 7, so on. There is no last term. Now such APs are called as the infinite AP, means uncountable. You cannot count here. So this is called as the infinite APs. Now see in the second AP, 2, 4, 6, 8, so on. Last term is how much is there? 100. So this is called as the finite AP, means you can count this one. So we'll call this one is the finite AP. Clear? Now see, remember what is the finite AP and the infinite AP. Now AP is denoted by the symbol A, A2, A3, A4, so on, AN. See, next point you have to remember, what is the general form of the AP? See? Yes. General form of AP. Let's see, what is the general form of the AP? First term A, second term A plus D, third term A plus 2D, and third term A plus 3D, so on, last term A plus N minus 1 into D. Now this is general form of the AP. Now see that, remember general form of the AP, A, comma A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, so on. Now A means first term, second term is, now see this is the A1, this is the A2, this is the A3 and A4, so on. Now this one is the last term, see what is the nth term, you can see that nth term, that is denoted by, see remember what is the nth term formula. I will write here, nth term formula, see what is the nth term formula, an is equal to a plus into bracket n minus 1 into d here. Correct? Now see, an means nth term, that is the last term, a plus, a first term plus n minus 1, n means number of the terms, remember where n means number of terms, A means first term, and A, B means what is that? Common difference. B means common difference. D means a common difference. Clear? Now see that, remember A1. See the one more point you have to remember. See these points are very important. Now A1 means first term. A2 means, how to write here, A plus common difference. Then A3 means third term, how to write the third term, A plus 2D, see that, less than 1. Now A4, how to write here, A plus 3D, now so on, clear? Now finally, this is what is that, nth term formula here. I hope you understood. Now last term, you can say that AN means last term, one more that name is for the last term, an is equal to, it is denoted by the symbol L also. Last term is denoted by the one more symbol, that is the small l or a an. I hope you understood. Now these all points you have to remember. One example you will see that. I hope you understood. Now next we example from the exercise number 5.2. We will see in the next period. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.